So today I thought I'd just cover a few questions you might have about Google Business Profile. Now you may have heard last week Google announced that Google My Business is no longer. You would have seen that video that I showed. And now you'll know that Google Business Profile has taken over. But a lot of you have been asking questions, what does this actually mean? Will this make dramatic changes to your business from now on? Is there anything to be concerned about or worried about? Well, I'm going to answer all your questions in this small, brief, but easy to follow video. So currently at the moment, the only real difference is the fact that you're beginning to see the logo change to Google Business Profile. Also, you'll notice that the control panel for your Google My Business is now being changed to Google Business Profile Manager. So there's a couple of just little technical changes, logo changes, just surface changes that's currently out. But what about those questions you've got about your reviews? Will they still remain? Will you be able to still update more than one business? How's that going to work going forward? Well, let me just take each question and I'll give you what I know as it currently stands. So first question, what does it actually mean to me and my business? Well, what it means is that Google wants you to, rather than update your business using the control panel, logging in and signing in, they're just wanting it to be a much more easy process. Why? Because they want you to update it on a more regular basis. And this is giving us an understanding that Google clearly thinks at the moment businesses are not giving enough reliable information. So why is that a good thing for you? Well, it means then that if Google's wanting reliable information, and if you've been following my videos, you'll know that's what we've been doing. All my subscribers have been learning how you can get your reliable information into Google. So nothing's really changed from the point of view of the principle of getting the information there, but how you go about getting that information is just going to get a little bit easier. Now, I asked you on my community, why do you feel Google's decided to make this change? And one or two of you have been saying, maybe it's just to cut the dead wood out, to get rid of those spammy sites, to get rid of those ones that perhaps haven't been claimed for some time. So this could be a bit of a clearing up act that Google's taken on, and that would make some sense. So one of the questions was from Leslie Mitchell, where she was interested to know about her verification. How does she go about that? Well, again, you'll notice that Google now is pushing hard towards making sure you can verify it from within the browser itself. So verification is going to get a lot easier going forward, and claiming businesses also will be a lot easier. So as much as there's just a superficial change from the logo point of view, verification is one of the first things Google's addressing. Now, Jennifer the other day asked, how does she go about making sure that she updates her profile? How does she do this? For some reason, I don't see an option to edit my Google website. Well, this is through the browser, but it could just be that you've not logged into your browser using the same account that your business has been registered to. So when you log into your browser or your Chrome, make sure that you at the same time are using the correct Gmail account that's associated with your logging in to your business. And then the two should marry up. And you can tell whether that's going to happen, because if you type into the Google search My Business, just put those words, or if you type in the name of your business, then you should see your business come up, and then you can start making the editing. Now, another question you've been asking is that some of the features aren't all there, they're missing. So how do you find all those features that you found in the control panel beforehand? Well, actually, a lot of them are hidden through the three dots. So when you log into the various areas on the browser, look for the three dots, click on there, and you'll then see a further depth to some of the areas that you might be looking for. Now, Thierry Leconte said, does that mean then that the 30 days that we've just gone through is now not usable? Is it now irrelevant? Absolutely not. Those 30 days, all the information about how to update your posts, how to update your listing, your settings, how to make sure you're seen on Google Maps, understanding the right keywords, adding products, adding services, getting the free website optimized, all those things that are to do with a 30-day challenge we did last month, they're all still relevant. The difference is, how do you now put that information into your Google My Business profile? Well, instead of going through the control panel, Google's wanting you to go through the browser. And so once you understand that the two are very similar, it's just a slightly different change in how you put that information. Once you get used to adding to your profile, then a case of follow the 30 steps, but just find the access to the information in a slightly different way to the back end of your business. Peter Perris asked, will this affect your Google My Business reviews? Well, I wouldn't have thought so. So we don't know for sure what's going to be affected from these updates because they'll be gradually rolling them out over the next few months. There's been a lot of effort to make sure the reviews are trustworthy by Google. And so that would imply then that the reviews will remain a feature going forward. Now, we do be asked an interesting question regarding the security of your browser. He says, if you just change or update your business info just in the browser, how do you keep someone from hijacking your GBP, your Google Business Profile? Well, the fact is you don't just access it through the browser, but you access it through logging in or signing into your browser. So often a Chrome browser will enable you to log in. It keeps your bookmarks. It keeps a lot of information. It keeps your cookies and it associates it with your Gmail account. So the security is to do with your Gmail. You have to be logged in the first place for all this information to work. Pinpoint Local asks this question. How do you think this will be for digital marketing agencies that manage GBPs for local businesses? He manages 15 local businesses. So will that change the business model? Well, it will change it slightly because what Google Business Profile is about to do is to try and get business owners to do everything on a one-to-one basis for their business. But they do recognize that some businesses will have quite a few different areas to cover. So I think it's called Google Business Profile Manager. You'll be able to access that still for more than 10 businesses. If you've got less than 10, then I think you just log in on an individual basis and you'll select which one it is that you want to edit by just typing in my business or typing in the business name that's specific to your business. Andre Crawford just asked a question. So what happens to my Google My Business Profile now? Well, the fact is nothing's really changed. It is just literally a logo change for now. All the information is still there. So nothing's been lost. It's just been a change in the direction that Google's wanting to take. And that's, again, come out through the last couple of videos I've done. Others have asked, should I still use a business profile if I've got a website? Well, yes, the purpose of the Google Business Profile is to complement your website, to build on your branding, to get more people inquiring to your business. So like Google My Business is exactly the same. It complements your business and will provide inquiries through Google Maps and Google Search. And a question, can I use Google Business Profile if I don't have a shop front? And the answer is yes. It's been designed not only for shop fronts on the high street, but also for services and for any business really that needs customers to be found on a local basis. So if you cover a local area and you're into a local SEO, search engine optimization for your business, then Google Business Profile is certainly worth claiming yours, verifying it, optimizing it, and following the videos to help you optimize it and keep it up to date. And I mentioned in the video, this 30-day challenge of optimizing your business profile. So whether you've got Google My Business currently, whether you've been changed on the logo to Google Business Profile, head over to this video now and you'll learn how you can optimize it and get more inquiries straight away.